A to Z Unity Game Jam Tips. E. For my E-tip, I'm choosing end screens. Having a pop-up for when your player wins or loses the game is important feedback and allows you to show off stats they made throughout the level. I want to make it when the player gets the heart, they win, and when they get the spike, they lose. You want to go to Canvas, right-click, and add a panel. We're going to call this Lose Screen. And we're going to come back over here and we're going to make it fit our game a little bit better. You're going to right-click on your lose screen, hit text, and we're going to change the text to say you lost. We're going to add a button and we're going to make this button say retry. Create a new mono behavior script called end screens. To remove the update and start functions, we are going to add a public game object variable called lose screen. We're going to make a public void retry method. And at the top, add Unity Engine.scene management. Back inside of retry, write scene manager dot load scene, scene manager dot get active scene dot build index. We also need to come over here to our player script and we can add a public game object canvas and we can write canvas get component end screens lose screen set active true. Next, we're going to want to make a way for our player to stop moving whenever we die. That way you can't just walk around even though the lose screen is active. An easy way to do that is to type time.timescale equals zero, but it's going to stay zero unless we set it back to one. And so if we come back over here to our retry function, we can type on here time.timescale equals one. Back in Unity, come to our player and put the canvas into the variable. And we can apply this script to our canvas. Then we can add our lose screen into the lose screen variable. We need to make the button on the lose screen actually do the retry function. Now that the lose screen works, let's copy and paste it. And on this one, we're going to change the text to say, you win. And on the button, we can write something like main menu. We can rename this win screen. Then back in our code, we can Control D here to copy this line and we can change this to windscreen. Down here where I touch the heart, we can just copy and paste these two lines of code, but instead of saying lose screen, we can write windscreen and we can put the windscreen into the variable. And now if we hit play, when I touch the heart, I win. And when I touch the spike, I lose. And that's it. If this helped you at all, a like and subscribe would mean the world to me. Thanks for watching.